The place where you brought me from. Lord, I thank you for where I am today. I see you doing a new thing in my life. Lord, I'm grateful.
Good evening, America. Good evening, Japan. Good evening, China. Good evening, South Africa. You are welcome once again to the Dr. Jesus Show. It is wonderful to be here with you once again. I am not alone today. I have a very special guest who has joined me and who will be interacting not just with myself, but with you callers who will be calling much later. Let me very quickly introduce her to you now. And as we go on through the course of this program, you will hear more and more and more from the beautiful Miss Mfon Ekpo. You're very welcome.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. It's a great pleasure to have you.
Thank you.
Yeah. So tonight I bring to you a very special production that has me and Mfon before you. The very special theme we're handling is the theme of the woman. The woman, the woman, the woman. Her likes, her pains, her aches, the solutions to the problems that she might be facing, as a mother, as a sister, as a corporate, as an entity. It's a packed agenda. If you have friends who do not have Sky, all they need to do is go to www.bentelevision.com. Before I go any further, this is the point where I soak this session with the blood of Jesus. I soak the condolences with the blood of Jesus. I ask for the Spirit of the living God to take absolute control, take absolute preeminence, rule over the airwaves, Lord. It's all about you. We diminish that you can amplify. We diminish that you can be magnified. We give you all the glory. Glorify yourself in this session in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Viewers, as I've always entreated you in previous edits of the show, I've always ask that you see this show much like a river flowing. You know, back in Africa, some people who need access to water endeavor to do that by going to the stream. If you go to the river with a pail, you get a pail amount of water. If you go with a plate, you get a plate amount of water. If you go with a tanker and put the nozzle in, you get a tanker amount. What am I saying? I'm encouraging you to come as you are. Come with an open mind. Be ready to receive. It's a packed agenda. Between myself and Mfon, we are going to make sure that this evening goes without a hitch. And of course, grace of God by our side, you will go well in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, Mfon, let me very quickly introduce you. So much to say. Where do I start? You're the CEO of the Discovery Center.
Yes.
Well done, well done. Which in itself is a training organization. And who do you specialize in the training that you do with the Discovering Center?
Oh, we specialize in individuals and with organizations as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
So corporates,
public entities, and individuals.
When you say individuals, what type of individuals? C-level, directors of, heads of, the man on the street? What type of individuals are
they're
we talking about?
They're mainly C-level.
Okay,
mainly C-level. Mm-hmm. What we teach them is how to increase their impact, their influence, and their income, and to actually position them. Because a lot of C-level people are not where they're supposed to be.
Indeed, indeed.
Yes. So position them to where they're supposed to be so that they can then flourish in that particular spot. So, yes.
And given the type of focus we're having tonight, it is about the woman.
Absolutely.
About how she can excel.
Absolutely.
How she can expand. How she can moonshot.
Yes.
How she can come into her own.
Yes.
And actualize exactly as it has been written of her in the book of life. Amen. And the Lord said to Jeremiah, before you were born, I knew you. I ordained you. It stands to reason that for every woman out there, there is a destiny that God has prepurposed, has pre-planned. And yes, there's no reason why the ordinary man on the street cannot attain, or ordinary woman on the street cannot attain sea-level heights.
Absolutely.
Now, it's the intention of this program as well to showcase your many different facets.
Mm-hmm.
This is where I like to bring the attention of the viewers at home to the fact that you're a scholar. You're a development strategist as well. You have multiple degrees. I mean, help the audience understand your scholarly background. I beg you, before I let all the cats out of the bag.
So I'm a lawyer. I have, spent, the better part of my life, studying law. I have degrees in business law and social sciences, maritime law.
Maritime.
Yes, absolutely.
Not many women do that.
Absolutely.
Well done.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
And you also have, you're a certified trainer and coach.
Yes.
And you have two books you've written.
Yes.
Can you tell us a little about your books, please?
Two books I've written. The first one I co-authored with Brian Tracy. A lot of people who are in sales and just... basically, entrepreneurs know Brian Tracy.
He's a huge name.
He's a huge name in the sales industry. And if you want to, you know, take your business to another level.
Indeed.
And so, yes, I the first book is called Push Into the Front.
Oh, Push Into the Front.
Push Into the Front.
I like that. So this is, women, watch this show because you are going to learn how to accelerate, how to push to the front. Amen?
Absolutely. Amen.
Yes.
And then the second one is it's not aptly titled. It's called The Only Business Book You'll Ever Need.
Yeah,
that's a collaboration with a lot of entrepreneurs and Brian Tracy and some of you know Robert Allen and...
Robert Allen?
Oh, yes.
Oh,
so,
fantastic.
So what each person did was each person brought their best business strategy.
Indeed.
And put it in a book. And so that's why we call it The Only Business Book You'll Ever
Need.
Do you
have a chapter per person or...?
It's a chapter per person.
Fantastic.
On the best business secret. Absolutely.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes,
makes it quite a nugget to
right
have. That's the book on screen.
Yes.
Viewers watching at home, catch it on screen. Live from Ben TV Studios in Tottenham, London, we have The Best Business Book You'll Ever Need. This book actually won awards. Can you tell us about the awards you won with this particular book?
There's the Academy of Best-Selling Authors. So
yes.
This book was a bestseller, so it won the Golden Quill.
The National Academy of
Best-selling authors. Yes.
In Hollywood, in California.
Yes, in Hollywood.
Oh, fantastic. Well done.
Thank you.
Proud of you.
Thank you.
National treasure. Very, very good. And it's were one or two heights it attained in terms of its rating on Amazon.
Also,
it did very well on
absolutely.
Well.
So, in fact, what they do is how they rate the books is from this, you know, the best-selling author title, you get it from the ratings of how the book is when it hits the market. Of course, best-selling is best-selling. It means, you know...
No, but in this instance, I was a little bird who tells me it was best-selling across three categories. Very, very good, you know? And yes, anyway, we have it down that on top of the time you have trained as far as the British High Commission, Supreme Court of Nigeria, the National Judicial Institute, the National Assembly as well. Oh, this is fantastic. Tell us about the future project. You have some obligations and some...
Yeah, so I signed as the executive director of the Future Project.
What is the Future Project?
The Future Project is... we run Africa's largest youth awards. What we do is we connect young people. We focus on enterprise, leadership, and governance.
Just
to connect young people to the resources, to put them in the positions... and empower them so they're able to shape and structure how society is supposed to run. Young people make up 70% of the country.
Indeed.
They cannot be ignored.
No, not at all.
Absolutely.
Not
so,
at all.
Yes, that's what we focus on, how to empower young people in leadership, enterprise, and governance.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Well done.
Thank you.
And the titles are just, I think the only other person that has as many titles as this has been the former Archbishop of Canterbury, you know? He had 38 in all. Why not? What a man can do, a woman can do better. You are also a Mandela Washington Fellow.
Yes.
And you were in the pioneer set of President Obama's Young African Leaders Initiative.
Yes.
We have pictures to prove and they will come on screen as well. This is wonderful. Now, the caliber is what holds as a tantalizing prospect for us. We are going to have the opportunity during the show to engage with you, to dialogue with you. You are also above all of this, above all the titles, all the qualifications, all the kaleidoscopic facets of your multidimensional beauty.
Absolutely.
You're also a woman of faith.
Absolutely.
Or you are particularly a woman of faith.
Absolutely.
Please, it is a faith-based program. Help people understand where it is you're coming from the faith perspective, and what has helped as far as being a woman of faith is concerned. Please.
Well, you know, the Bible says your life is hid with Christ in God.
Amen.
I know that there is no way that I would have found myself if I didn't go into God.
Indeed.
Because if I'm hid in Him, I had to go into Him.
Yes.
He says, I'm in Him, He's in me. You find yourself in God.
In God, absolutely.
You know,
absolutely.
And I went to the Word of Faith Bible Institute.
With winners.
Absolutely.
I went earlier this year.
and
I will go again.
Absolutely. It was one of the best places that I learned about the Word of God and the living Word.
Absolutely.
As it is. And so So when God reveals himself to you that way, you are stripped of every other label of the world.
Yes.
And then God tells you exactly who you are in him. Absolutely. It's the reason there's nothing I can do outside. The word and God is what underpins everything I have done or I am.
There's a song that goes, Christ is my rock, my refuge, my stronghold.
Absolutely.
Firm as the tree root that clutches the land. He who has faith builds without worry.
Not so like the man who built up on sand.
I set my house on a solid foundation. Christ is my rock, the root of my soul recreation.
You know, that was
not even planned. Not even planned.
It's actually very interesting because he says Christ is the root of my soul's recreation.
Recreation.
We recreate as we go in life.
Indeed.
You recreate with the labels people put on you.
Absolutely.
You recreate. So the best kind of recreation is when you find it in Christ.
Yes.
He then tells you who exactly you're supposed to
be.
That is it.
The little story I've told on the show before, and for the purposes of your ears, you may or may not have heard this before. I'll gladly share the story for the benefits of our users who may not have heard the story before. Way back in 2008, I joined Mountain of Fire then. And what happens when you give your soul to Christ first time is that he bombards you with information about what he has created you to be. I got the message telling me that 53 countries were waiting. It didn't make sense then. It took me 3 years later to eventually decode, Africa has 53 countries. I'm thinking, what? 3 years later, I decoded it. But if I had not been a born-again Christian, if I had not accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, it would have been, my spiritual ears would have been blocked.
Absolutely.
I would not have heard that message. Mm. We give God the glory because he sets us on that road called straight. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Now, this is where we dive in to the meat of the proposition of tonight's program. The number that you will be calling much later, because we are going to be opening up the lines to our callers watching us from home, where you can call us, ask for a word or two, a prayer, particularly women. Tonight is a very woman-focused night. Do you want to do well? Do you want to achieve destiny? Do you want to actualize? Do you want to optimize that life? Do you want to hold, embrace that tangible that God has ordained for you? It need not be an abstract concept.
Mm-hmm.
Stay tuned. Just keep your eye on the program. We are coming before you. Dr. Jesus Show, Ben Television. My name, Pastor Sandra Oba. With me, Mfon Ekpo, and we will do our best to bring the word of God to you. Amen.
Amen.
Now, why you need to watch this program is that because tonight we are dealing with the subject of destiny. What is destiny? I am going to be engaging you tonight from my second book ever. It's called Woman, 50 Destinies That You Must Reject. Mm. Yes, if you were to ask any woman out there, what type of destiny do you want? Oh, yes. She can be full of words about what type of destiny she wants. She wants to be rich. She wants to be successful. She wants to be loved. She wants to be a homemaker. She wants to be the ultimate helpmate. All of that. But it's also wise to be able to delve into what type of destinies you do not want. What I have done in my book, 50 Destinies You Must Reject, is given you 50 different translations of the type of destiny you do not want. We'll be going through this book much later, taking some of the characteristics that certainly you do not want to replicate in your life.
Yes.
I've dealt with it from a secular point of view, using everyday language, everyday idioms, everyday animated objects, the onions, the dustbin, the dropout, the hair comb, the relaxer. Believe it or not, yes, I have described those characteristics, you know, in the context that would make sense. Going forward as well, there's a biblical perspective on the question of destiny as well. There are biblical matriarchs after the order of Ruth, after the order of Esther, after the order of Sarah, after the order of Rebecca, after the order of Jael, my favorite. Oh, what a decisive woman. She hammered that nail into Sisera's head. And she pinned him straight to death. Oh, yes. We need to be as decisive when we move women as Jael, one of my favorite matriarchs, and so many, many more women that we should aim to be like. But equally on the flip side, what I've also done in this wonderful book, 50 Destinies You Must Reject, is taking the time to give you about 12 to 13 different women whose destinies you do not want. I'm talking about women like Vashti, women like Jezebel, and such like, women like Lot's wife. We will come to that. Amen.
Amen.
So the way I describe destiny in this book is I've described destiny as God's agenda for your life.
Mm-hmm.
This is, if you go to page number 14, okay. I'm going to ask you to please read some of those characteristics out, awesome. Please. Yeah, page number 14.
Awesome.
So what is destiny? God's agenda for your life, the reason why you were born. It's the original divine intention for your life. It's your divine roadmap in life. It is your mission on this earth. Which other bullet points can you help us with to describe the topic of destiny?
It is what God has in mind when he fashioned you and sent you here.
Fantastic.
It's the expectation of heaven over your life.
Very good.
And it's the original divine intention for your life.
Mm-hmm.
I particularly like the fact that you pointed out that it is the divine blueprint for your life.
Absolutely. Blueprint. What is a blueprint? A blueprint is a map.
Absolutely.
Your blueprint shows you the course, shows you the way to go. Mm-hmm. And this is a very nice place to be able to moot the very important news that we have for our viewers today. We'll hear more and more about it. But for the purposes of you, help us. We have a program that you are in London, especially to handle.
Yes.
Normally, you're based in Abuja.
Yes.
With your Discovery Center, yes. Abuja, Nigeria.
Yes.
But for the purposes of this program, you are in the UK.
Yes.
Help us understand a little more, I beg you, the nature of this program. What is it called? And how is it? Why is it? Please help us.
So the seminar is called The Blueprint of How.
Blueprint of How.
Yes. That is why I like the fact that you define destiny in your book as a divine blueprint. A blueprint is almost like a skeletal structure of how something is supposed to be built, formed, or manufactured.
Yes.
Now, a lot of women, and this seminar is targeted at women, a lot of women have found out who they'd want to be, you know, who they know when. I mean, if all their ducks were in the row, they would do it today, you know. But the thing about it is they just don't know how. How do I transition from who I am now to that person that I constantly see in my head?
And the how is the trick of it.
The how is the trick. Ideas are a dime and a dozen. How do I execute them?
Indeed.
How do I use, absolutely, how do I use the skills to create an impact, an income, an influence? How?
Business at home.
Absolutely. So the question most of the time I get from women is how?
Okay.
You say I'm all these things. You say I can do all these things. Thank you. But how?
So what are the tangibles that women watching this show, or women who do attend, those who have already paid and will turn up on the day, what are they hoping to get from this program? What are the tangibles? Checklists, plans, proposals, remedial actions? Help us.
Well, first of all, a lot of times, we're frustrated on the journey just because we don't have a plan.
Indeed.
So one of the tangibles, in fact, the core tangible, is that everyone leaves the seminar with a plan of execution.
Uh-huh.
These are the steps I can take from where I am. Mm-hmm. A lot of times we have visions and dreams and we have goals and things, but they seem so big.
Indeed.
We're paralyzed because it's so big. Like, where do we start from?
Indeed.
So everyone leaves there with at least a five-step, a six-step process.
A believable plan.
A believable, tangible, breathing plan to start from where you are.
Do you handhold them after the program, or is it just a one-off? How is the relationship building, the customer service element of it?
Mm-hmm.
Because these women, I can assure you, they would want to continue that relationship with you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a social media strategy that you use to handhold them?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a customer telephone coaching type proposition that you use to handle them? Help our viewers understand.
There has to be, because the journey is not a one-off journey.
Mm-hmm.
You don't just learn something in a day and say, yes, I got it, I can execute.
Yes.
So what we do after the seminar is there's a monthly coaching session.
Very good.
There is a monthly checkup. Where are you on your plan?
According to that plan.
Absolutely. When you're frustrated, we pick you up. We say, okay, there's clarity. Clarity is a journey.
Indeed.
You don't get clarity. Clarity is not a one-off.
No,
never with life. Absolutely.
Well done. Well done. So opportunity for handholding, opportunities to make sure that time and time again, when you deviate from that route you've agreed to, you've signed to, you get back to it.
Yes.
You get back to it.
Yes.
You get back to it. Almost akin to an experience, almost you're helping the woman birth forth her idea, that midwife mentality.
Mm-hmm.
So you're helping them push forth, put to bed,
absolutely,
put out.
Absolutely.
Yes. Well done. Well done.
Thank you.
So why is it important that the show is listened to from wherever it is you're listening to us, be it from Nigeria. We've had callers in the past from Italy, from Netherlands, from Spain, from Portugal, all sorts of places. And I welcome you. If you're watching this program in Europe, be on standby in a few minutes. I'll be releasing the telephone number that you can use to call. If you're a woman in business, if you're a woman in academics, if you're a woman with marital problems, if you're a woman seeking the fruit of the womb, if you are WOMAN, call us. We are here. We are women of faith. We are women of God. We will handhold you. We will intercede for your situation, and God will hear us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The question of destiny. People think they can just walk into destiny, but that is not so. Destiny is something that needs a fight. You must contend with. I mean, God said to the children of Israel, I've given you the land, but you must contend with.
Yes.
You must contend with. Why? So in the issue of on the question of the plan that you help women construct,
yes,
during your session,
yes,
how is that the issue of contention? How is it dealt with? How is it you're able to help this woman, women pick out? Because it can be quite a rude awakening for people to be absolutely true to what it is they know they fall short in. How do you help them pick themselves up? How do you help them contend with the not so pleasant parts of themselves before they can optimize? Because they say to learn, to change, you have to unlearn what you've learned before.
Absolutely.
And then relearn.
Absolutely.
Is that thawing and then refreezing state of change?
Absolutely.
How does that happen?
Okay, so first of all, I just want to ask you a question. All work and no play makes what? Makes Jack
a dull boy and Jill a dull girl.
Absolutely.
Yes.
So if I asked you, when exactly did you learn that? Can you tell me the exact name of the place, time, and space you learned that all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy? No. So a lot of times we have picked up things.
Yes.
We don't know that we have learned.
Indeed.
It's the same way you can't identify where you learned all work and no play makes Jack or Jill a dull boy or girl.
So subconsciously.
Soaked in experiences.
Absorbed learnings and thinkings.
Absolutely. Yes. Limiting beliefs that stop us from birthing this thing. Someone says something like, nobody can have it all. And something sticks in your head, you can have it all. Or, some people are, the lucky ones, just not you. Money doesn't grow.
It doesn't. All those kind of things.
But where do we get it from? So what the seminar does is that, like you said, you likened it to birth.
Indeed.
Which is very apt.
Yes.
Women are not only placed on the earth to birth children.
Indeed.
They have God-given ideas. And so what we do is that we stand in the stead of midwives and say, now you push.
Absolutely.
Now you don't.
The midwife anointing.
Absolutely. Yes. Now you, and a lot of times if you ask any woman who has birthed, there comes a point in time in the birthing process where they're just tired.
Indeed.
They want to stop.
Indeed.
And the journey of birthing anything plus your dream, which is what you were asking, you will get tired.
Yes.
But you need someone. At that time, the strength is not yours.
It's not.
You need someone to say, look, you're about to. I can literally see the head of the baby.
Indeed.
You need to give me your strength.
You must bring forth.
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
And God said, I will not get you to and not cause you to.
Absolutely. To put forth.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Very correct. Just one or two more bullet points to just tie down the concept of what destiny means.
Mm.
I've got it as the instruction that your manufacturer, our God, has programmed into you to fulfill in life. Your destiny is when you find your place in the world. Your destiny is that one thing, core thing that you're known for. In the world of business, we refer to this as core competency, Now, to every man or woman with a destiny, there will always be conspiracies, there will always be fightings, there will always be contentions. To every man or woman with a colorful destiny, there will always be a rage from the pit of hell that says, you want to have this, we don't want you to have it.
Mm-hmm.
You must fight the good fight. Amen.
Amen.
Now, everybody watching this program, particularly women, it's my sincere prayer for you that in the mighty name of Jesus, any chaos, any disorder, any clutter that has deviated your thinking, that has deviated the way that God has chosen for you to go, that has put you on another course, anything but that road called straight, in the mighty name of Jesus, as we pray with you tonight, the number you need to call much later is 0208 808-0693. There you go. I've released the number, 0208-808-0693. We're about 5 minutes into break. We're just about to go into break. Hence, I've released that number. So certainly, the second part of the show helps us to understand how it is that we can pray for you, what it is that the hand-holding experience, the birthing experience, the support system, particularly using the blueprint of HOW, which is a seminar that Nfonekpo is organizing. When is that? Please help us understand the dates and the timings of that seminar, the location, the dates, the timing, please.
Oh, the seminar is on the 23rd of April, which is on Saturday.
On this Saturday coming.
Yes, this
fantastic.
Saturday
and
coming.
Where can people get more information today? I mean, they're watching this program and they're thinking, we want to go there. Mm-hmm. We want to be there. What do we do? It's an exclusive.
Yes, it's
that is rather exclusive.
It is exclusive.
But not exclusive enough that you cannot absorb more numbers. And we are opening the floor tonight. Please let our listeners and our watchers know the telephone number to get you on.
Okay. The telephone number, because the online registration is closed, mm-hmm. if you want to come for the seminar now, you have to call the number. Mm-hmm. It's 023-817-84953. Mm-hmm. That's 023-817-84953 to register for the seminar. You say, look, I'm uncertain about how to live out my dreams. Mm. I have a lot of ideas. Mm. I'm just stuck on execution.
Indeed.
I'm afraid that I will continue living my life like this, literally.
In a roundabout.
In a roundabout.
Never go around.
Absolutely.
A never-ending story.
And I keep on thinking of this person that I am and all the things that I want to do.
Yes.
But I just don't know how.
Yes.
This seminar is for you.
It is for you.
We will help you navigate the house.
Navigate.
From where you are.
Yes.
From where you are.